Greetings from West Lafayette, Indiana. Student life creates a dynamic out-of-classroom experience at Purdue University. Dedicated professionals in student life help Boilermakers find their campus home. We work tirelessly to support students and to help them pursue their dreams. Our work brings together housing, activities, arts, people, programs, and more to create a vibrant residential campus experience. In student life, our parent and family connections area is Purdue's critical point of contact for our families. Our team provides parents and families with information, resources, tools, and more. We recognize that families are a key part of student success, and we are excited to engage families as partners throughout their Boilermakers educational journey. Hail Purdue!
Purdue Parent and Family Connections, in collaboration with Student Life and other partners across the campus, creates a series of Purdue family videos throughout the year. The videos communicate topics of interest to educate and inform families about services, tools, and resources.
I'm a proud member of the Office of the Dean of Students under the Division of Student Life. I arrived at Purdue in 19 as a graduate student from the South, and I've navigated life from many tracks as a Boilermaker, a graduate student, a teaching assistant or a TA, a visiting professor, a lecturer, a director of a student success program, an advisor, a mentor, a senior faculty fellow, and now as an associate dean of education and advocacy. I am Dr. Zenephia Evans. As a graduate student, I navigated doubt about failing my first round or two of exams, and I adjusted to the cold temperatures and the lack of a supportive network, which tempted me on many occasions to board the midnight train back to Georgia, if I can borrow the phrase from Gladys Knight and the Fellas. I eventually formed a community of support and overcame the shame of being lost and adopted help-seeking tendencies that allowed for success on my Boilermaker track. My days of instructing non-science majors that needed a science elective came with a daily reminder of, I don't want to be in this class, and it needs to be an easy A. I became creative to encourage help seeking by reaching out to those students that earned 79 and below on the exams. In addition, I wanted to celebrate those that earned 80 and above. I transitioned from teaching to administrative roles and met a ninth grader that wasn't so sure if college was a good landing spot. We stayed in touch, and as the student completed school in Indianapolis and matriculated to Purdue, she enrolled in my course. Life was not kind to this student, as she lost her father during her first year at Purdue. Then subsequently, her mother, grandmother, and aunt died shortly after graduation. Illness of this Purdue alum had us looking into a medical power of attorney so that I could speak on her behalf, and it led us ultimately to our adoption. As a mother to a Purdue alum that I mentored during her tenure as a student, and doing the same for so many others, I want to share my tips on coaching students to success and provide information on campus resources that I want to be beneficial. It is my desire to share tips on coaching your student to prepare for college exams. These tips will help students stay on the passing track as a Boilermaker and to know the helpful resource stops along the way from various academic areas. Know that these tips on helping students are taken from interacting with students that have spanned the range from graduating with honors, barely graduating, or leaving prior to completion. One thing I've learned is that students and parents should have an in-depth conversation around expectations, abilities, and reality checkups. Now the tips. 1, differentiate between reading the material, grasping versus memorizing concepts, reviewing concepts, and being able to recall the concepts on test days. The days of regurgitating testing materials are in the rearview mirror. An application of the material is on the horizon. For instance, I would not ask students on a test how many ATPs are produced during glycolysis. I would ask them, if you manufacture 2 less than normal, how many ATPs would be produced? Not regurgitation, but application of material. Tip 2, pre-exam preparation. Exams are part of the educational journey that allow us to ascertain if a student has mastered the concepts in their chosen area of interest. The transition from high school to college will require adjustments and continual recalculations. As many students admit, they never had to study in high school. And I know it to be true that the days of sleeping on books for osmosis to occur is really a thing of the past. If only I had a dollar for each student that said, "I need to learn how to study in college," I could retire and follow the WTA all around the world to see tennis matches. What are some keys to studying? How a student studies. Do they read the material? Do they write and rewrite the notes? Do they need to verbalize the material? Do they teach it to others? Or do they make up songs like I did to learn the material? When a student studies, an all-nighter versus a 7 to 10 day study plan? I remember staying up with a group of friends all night to help them study and overslept the next day of the exam. And they didn't wake me up either. What the student will need to study. Are they only studying the notes that they've taken in class? What about the other material that is reading or pre-material you need to learn? What will or will not be shared with the students to study? Study guides may be a thing of the past, and the class syllabi is really the roadmap for learning. Students also need to be prepared for the type of test. Is it multiple choice? Is it short answer? Is it essay? So they know what they're getting into. Where a student studies is important. I tried to study in my room, but the bed would win out every time. And if I studied at the desk, I spent more time cleaning off the desk than studying. Are they studying with friends in a residence hall? Are they studying in an academic building? Are they studying at that beautiful new library? The location of studying will matter, as students will have to navigate distractions. Who are you studying with? Are you studying with people that are smarter than you? Are you studying with people at the same level? Are you studying with those people that don't know as much as you do? That will determine the time you spend learning, the time you spend teaching, and the time you spend helping. Exam day. Know the time and location of the exam. We have the pleasure of interacting with so many students that overslept or did not know where their exam was being given. I encourage students to read the full exam because I would often answer questions further down in the exam. Another point that's really simple, answer the easy questions first and then go back to the harder questions. When you would look at an exam that I've taken, I made notes all over the exam so that I could, if I recall something, I would write it down. And that allows students to dissect the questions to make sure they're responding to the question. Is the question asking what is blank or what is not blank? Post-exam learning. I had office hours after the exam for students to come in to the post-exam learning. They were some of the loneliest hours I spent on campus. Students can review the material to know what gave them the points and where they missed points from the concepts. Then to do an assessment and review the material of concepts that they did not grasp, and that might build on the next material moving forward. Is it that a student did not read the question, they did not answer the question directly, or they did not understand the concept to adequately respond to the question? Students take success of that first exam if they earn the grade that they wanted and build on it. If they didn't earn the grade that they wanted on the first exam, take the experience of the first exam to learn something. What recalculations are needed for success? And this is a time that students have to be honest with self and not make excuses, but to adapt, to grow, and to learn. I often tell students, we are gifted with 24 hours each day. I don't like to use the word time management, as I don't manage time, or else I would stop it for a few months to play catch up. I can, however, manage how I use the time that I have by keeping track of my usage. It will be handy for students to note the time that they're spending reading, studying, working out at the gym, hanging out with friends, and we have an app called Shovel that will allow them to do just that. I remember some students that came to Purdue and said, as students at Purdue, we're only going to study from 8 to 6, Monday through Friday. I said, okay. After first exams, I asked, how was that going for you? We needed to make some recalculations. Notice that I've given some tips, and now there are many resources on campus that will assist students. You can search for these resources by going to the Purdue Office of the Dean of Students Resources to learn a lot more. Some of these resources include, but are not limited to, the Helen Bass Williams Academic Success Center. They not only have workshops, but student ambassadors to help students. There's a huge study area in Shreve Hall that allows for different tutors to come in and help with students. There are major related resource rooms that are in some of the colleges that students need to find. We have free tutors on campus. Also, some students use tutoring as a way to help with their college education, so there are paid tutors. So have your students explore the one that will work best for them. Families, you can find multiple resources on this page, Purdue Office of the Dean of Students Resources. We just today focused on academic support. I would like to mention that students need to always take note of their final exam schedules and when the final exam dates will be released. This will, one, allow the students to make sure that they're only taking two finals in a day and not three. Secondly, it allows for you to plan the departure from the universities accordingly, because you don't want to schedule a flight to return home on Thursday when you have a Saturday final. And lastly, note that final means done, and there are no more points on the table at that time. As a parent, you know your students best, and these tips are to assist in their success on their Boilermaker train. And know that there are many academic resource stops along the way that may be useful. As a parent, it's important to play to your students' strengths and help them to navigate their challenges. And finally, as a Purdue alum, as a mother of a Purdue alum, and a current member of the Student Life team, I'm excited and honored to partner with families to help students flourish, to learn, and matriculate to the next phase of life. Each year, I celebrate my adoption day on the 1st of October, and my daughter said to me, "Mama, I had selective actions to your sage advice. And I wonder how my outcomes would have differed if. I stopped her at that point and I said, "No worries, child of mine. Your parenting turn is just around the corner, and you can share the lessons that will also have selective actions." Boiler up, hammer down, and hail Purdue.
Purdue Parent and Family Connections appreciates our parents and families. We are grateful for your engagement. We hope that the Purdue Family video was of interest to you, provided new knowledge, and informed you about services, tools, and resources. Scan the QR code with your phone to share feedback. Thank you for watching.